This episode of Tutcast is brought to you by GDIformoms.com. Visit today and let them help you build a better business, not only for yourself, but by yourself. GDIformoms.com. Hey there, and welcome to another Photoshop tutorial from Tutcast.com. And in this tutorial, I'm going to be showing you how to create an iMac in Photoshop from scratch. The iMac you see in front of you was created completely in Photoshop, except for the desktop background, which I'm not going to show during this tutorial. So we're going to create it at a nice big size, 512 by 512, and it looks great as a desktop icon, as you can see up in this top right corner. So let's begin. We're going to go to File, New, and enter the dimensions of 512 by 512, and click OK. And here's our new document, and we're going to start off by creating the screen. And to do that, we're going to grab our rounded rectangle tool right over here. At the top, we're going to set the radius to 20, style none, and the color is going to be set to black for now, just so we can see it on the background. And when you're ready, start dragging out your screen, just like this, and let go when you have your screen size set. There we go. Now we're going to apply a layer style to this screen by going to Layer, Layer Style, and then Gradient Overlay. And here's our Gradient Overlay dialog box. The first thing we need to do, we need to set the angle, move this over here, to 0, just so it's a horizontal gradient, and then click on the gradient bar to bring up the gradient editor. We're going to double click on the far left node, and we're going to make it a nice gray color, just like that. And we're going to double click on the far right node and make it a little bit lighter than the previous color that you set. There you go. And click OK, click OK, and click OK. Now the next thing we're going to do, we're going to make the actual screen, the black area on the screen. So to do that, what I'm going to do, I'm going to duplicate this layer by dragging it down to the new layer icon at the bottom. What I'm going to do now, I'm going to grab my direct selection tool out of the tools palette. And using my shift key, I'm going to hold down shift and drag and select the bottom nodes, all the bottom nodes like this. Now I'm going to hold down shift and press my up arrow key to bring it up a little bit. I'm going to do the exact same thing for the right nodes and the left nodes. I'm going to push it in just a little bit. Just like that. And of course, the top nodes. There we go. And once again, we're going to go back to Layer, Layer Style, Gradient Overlay. And this time, we're going to apply a nice dark gradient. So we're going to double click on the far left, make it nice and dark, double click on the far right, and make it a little bit lighter. Just like that. And once that's done, I'm just going to lighten this up a little bit. We're going to apply a stroke. So we're going to click on stroke right here, which basically adds an outline. But instead of going outside the shape, we're going to go inside the shape. So under position, we're going to set it to inside. And the color is going to be set to black. And we're going to increase the size to approximately, let's say, 18. And when you're done, click OK. So we have the basic screen set up. We need to make this base, as you can see here. Now this is a pretty difficult shape to work with, and it mostly looks the way it does because of the gradient, and I'm going to show you the gradient settings in a second. But let's deal with the actual shape. To create this shape, we're going to be using the pen tool, which is in our tools palette right over here. And at the top, we're going to make sure the first option is checked on, the create new shape layer option, style set to none, and color black. So here we go. We're going to draw out the shape of the base. It's a little bit confusing, so stick with me. We're going to zoom in here so we can see what we're doing. We're going to start around this area here. We're going to click, holding down shift, we're going to click right around there and then drag your mouse inwards a little bit to create a curve. Now holding down alt or option, we're going to click on the last node that we created to get rid of that bottom curve. Holding down shift, we're going to click diagonally right around there. Now we're going to go all the way over here, holding down shift, click there, click diagonally right around there, holding down shift, click, and then drag your mouse to create that curve. Now it may take a few times to actually get the perfect shape, but you can edit it later on, which we're going to do now. So we're going to zoom in even more, and grabbing our direct selection tool right over here, we're going to make sure all the nodes line up perfectly. So we're going to drag a ruler, make sure these nodes line up, looks like they do. Make sure these line up, it looks like they do. What we're going to do, we need to make that bottom curve right around here. So we're going to right click on this path, click add anchor point right in this area here, and do the exact same thing on this side here. We're going to select both of those new nodes by holding down shift and dragging on them, and then moving it down just a little bit, just like that. And then you can adjust their curves to make it a little more curvy. There we go. So we have the basic shape. It could use a little bit more work, but for now, it's pretty good. I'm going to move these down just a little bit. There we go. So now for the layer style. Now this was a little bit difficult to get perfect, so I'm going to show you what I had. The gradient overlay that we used is a 90 degree angle, and this is the gradient editor right here. So we have a nice light gray color on the left, followed by a little bit of a darker color, followed by a nice light color, darker, and then a little bit lighter than that. So pause the video, take a look at this gradient right here, and try and duplicate it as best as possible. And if we apply this to our layer, we're going to copy this layer style, and I'm going to apply it to this one. It's looking somewhat decent. It's not perfect. The nodes are a little bit off in some areas. But it'll definitely give you a starting point, just like that. So we need to make that look a little bit more 3D right now. So what we're going to do, we're going to hold down Alt and press down a few times. 1, 2, 3, 4. And you'll notice it's copied that layer a few times. 1, 2, 3, and 4. We're going to hold down Shift or Control and select all of them, all the copies, and merge them by going to Layer, Merge Layers, and then moving it below the previous layer. Now we're going to go to Layer, Layer Style, Gradient Overlay. The angle is going to be now set to 0. We're going to make the gradient go from a nice gray color like this to a little bit lighter in the center. I'm going to move this in the center a little bit. And the end color is going to be a little bit darker, just like that. Click OK, click OK, and click OK. So there is the base. It's a little bit off. What we could have done, if you go back to the gradient editor, add one more here, and one more here, and make the end nodes a little bit darker, just so it looks like it's curving around. And of course, you can go ahead and add a drop shadow, 90 degree angle, decrease the size a little bit, distance, just to make it look a little bit more 3D. So it's looking somewhat decent, not perfect, but looking pretty good for a very short amount of time. Another thing you can do, if we zoom in here on this one, I added a few highlights right in this area here. So we can do that by going to our base layer, holding down Command or Control and selecting it just like that, and using the lasso tool to get rid of everything except a nice angled reflection just like this. And once that's done, create a new layer, fill it with white, go to Filter, Blur, Gaussian Blur, and just blur it just a little bit, and decrease the opacity. So we have a nice little reflection in that area there. Now if we compare it to the original, the base on the original is a little bit wider than the one that we created. Obviously you would spend more time and make sure it matches the actual iMac as best as possible. I'm just showing you a brief overview of how it can be done. Also, the Apple symbol, you can find that basically anywhere. Go to Google. The reflection up here is very simple. We can go over to our screen layer, this one right here, hold down Command or Control, select it, grab our lasso tool, hold down Alt or Option, and select the area we don't want selected. Whoops. Get rid of that as well. Create a new layer, grab our gradient tool, make sure it's set to foreground to transparent, and very simply make a gradient like that, and then decrease the opacity to around 20 or 30%. So there we go, we've created an iMac in Photoshop. Obviously it's not perfect, it's not very accurate. You would obviously spend a lot more time to perfect everything on it. The one on the left, which I created, obviously didn't take me only 10 minutes. I spent a lot longer to perfect every little detail on the iMac. So I hope you've picked up on some tips and apply it to your designs. I'd love to see what you come up with. Upload a video response, post it on this video here. I'll probably accept it as long as it's relevant. And until next time, this is Howard from Tutcast.com. Take care.